It's a book, first of all, the title is too long. 2 years, 8 months, 28 nights. I'm sorry for that. But of course, that's if you do the mathematics, that's 1,001 nights. So in a way, it's like a 1,001 night story, but a very contemporary one, which is set in contemporary New York. And, you know, it's about the world we live in, which is full of monsters, which show up to eat us, and we have to fight back. So it's about a battle between monsters and human beings. I don't think words can cure anything. I don't want to overclaim what words can do. But what they can do, I think, is to change the way people think about things, you know? And I think one of the things that writers can do is to ask people to think more interestingly about things than journalism does. Because the problem is we are presented with the world in a very, in a way, a very orthodox, narrow format, you know, and people begin to think like that. And what fiction, what literature can do is to broaden the range of your response. You begin to see the world in a more complicated and interesting way. You know, that it can do. I don't think it fix anything. You know, I was a student of history originally, and one of the things you learn from the study of history is that what you expect to happen is what never happens. You know, history goes in very unexpected directions, you know. And so the fact that everything may look terrible, you know, it doesn't mean that it will inevitably be terrible. It could be worse than that, or it could be better than that, but it will be different than what we expect, you know. And you have to therefore not give up. How can you give up when the world is so strange? The world changes so much so quickly and moves in such unexpected directions. You know, if we were standing here in 1989, and I said to you, the Soviet Union will not exist at Christmas, you would have thought I was crazy, you know, and yet that's what happened. So what I'm saying is that that can happen. The world can make incredible changes very, very quickly. And we have to hope that those are good changes. You know, I mean, you in France at least managed to not make the terrible mistake that the Americans made and that the British made. So, you know, you're a bit ahead of the game right now.